Well, hello again, sports bettors. It's Jonathan here from the School of Bets. And in this video, we're going to take a look at five ways you can improve your live betting on tennis. Okay, so why is tennis such a great sport to bet on live? There's a few reasons. The first one is there are endless games. It's a year-round sport, it has a fantastic world tour and some subsidiary tours that have plenty of betting on them. But it's year-round, there's a ton of games, and they are so statistically measurable. So there's so many aspects of the game that can be quantified with numbers, which then creates a ton of markets for you to bet on. The final reason it's such a great sport to bet on is it has huge momentum swings, or it can have huge momentum swings. It is a game pitting two individuals against each other, and a small change in tactic, a small change in momentum can see a big change in scoreline and in the flow of the game. It's a fantastic sport to bet on live. Okay, the first tip to help you improve your live betting on tennis is to buy the dip. And what I mean by that is, if you have assessed a game pre-game and you particularly like a certain player, and this tip actually works more so where you've got quite an even matchup odds-wise or potentially form-wise, if you like a player, you've analyzed and you really like that player, and then when the game starts, they fall behind early. And I'm talking, let's talk Grand Slam, let's talk best of five matches where there's quite a long time takes place to get to the eventual winner. If your guy falls behind early, if your player falls behind early, there's an opportunity there to access slightly improved odds. If you firmly believe that they are the better player in the game, they are going to have to, at points in a five-set match, overcome momentum shifts against them. So if that happens early on in the game, buy the dip. Get the better price and see how you go. The second tip to improve your live betting on tennis is to bet against the player that can't miss. Now, what I'm talking about here is in a particularly a five-set match, if you see early on or in the early stages of a game, a player who is just hitting everything, they can't miss, they're lights out, they're hitting lines, left corners, left, right, and center, winners all over the court, that sometimes is reflected in the odds, because what bettors around the world are doing, they're not always watching the game, they're just watching the score changes, and they're jumping on and betting based on scoring changes. However, if you're watching the game and the player seems to be lights out but hitting low percentage shots with a high degree of accuracy, oftentimes over the length of a five set match, that changes. And the player that they're facing knows that, they hang tough, they grind it out, and they get back into the game. So if you bet against the player that can't miss and expect that at some point they will start missing, and if they start missing, they're going to start creating unforced errors. And unforced errors is what actually causes players to lose games. Unforced errors are toxic to a player's game. So if they're hitting everything in at the start of the game, there's a big chance they're going to start missing. Use it to your advantage. Bet against the player that can't miss. The third tip to improve your live betting on tennis is to use the stoppages that come up in tennis to your advantage. We know that at the end of every three games, there's a change of ends. And so at that point in time, there's going to be stoppages. There's also stoppages between sets and so on. There's sometimes injury timeouts. There's a whole variety of things that cause stoppages in the general play of tennis. That just buys you that small amount of time to assess the odds with a little bit more detail so that you can make a bit more of an informed decision. A lot of the sports books at the moment are even offering point by point betting. It's high risk, it's dangerous, a good way to lose money, it's fun, but great way to lose money. Use the stoppages in tennis to make a little bit more of an informed decision and without that feeling of being rushed that often comes when you're betting live. The fourth tip to improve your live betting on tennis is to become a weather expert. Now, I don't mean by that go and do a meteorology degree and understand high and low pressure systems and all of that. What I mean is just learn how to predict or access the information so that you know what the weather might be doing, in particular in events that are outdoors. Now, we know there are plenty of courts on particularly some of the major Grand Slam events that are covered, but tennis is an outdoor sport essentially, and weather plays a part. And what happens is you have a player who has momentum and he's going well in a game, and then the rain comes or then the heat rule is enforced, and a stoppage that is outside of the normal realms of tennis occurs. That can break momentum. So if you can foresee a stoppage coming and you feel like there's enough time in a game for a player who is currently at the longer odds, not quite the favorite, to come back, then potentially there's an opportunity to bet on them or back them prior to the weather impact occurring. And be thinking to yourself, well, when the stoppage occurs, they're gonna go and assess some video. They're probably gonna somehow get in contact with their coach, rethink the tactics, and the game can be totally different when they come back, and you may well be sitting on some real value odds. So become a weather expert. It can help you bet live on tennis. Fifth tip to help you bet live on tennis is actually focused on one particular statistic, and that is breakpoint opportunities. Now, we know in tennis there's a huge momentum shift when a break of serve occurs, particularly in men's tennis, where serving is at such a high standard in that top 100 that a break of serve may just happen the one time in the set, and it's the difference between winning and losing the set. So there is a statistic you can access live, which is breakpoint opportunities. Now, if you have a player in a game that's very tight, or they might even be slightly behind, but you look at the statistics and you understand that they have actually had quite a few breakpoint opportunities, and those opportunities may continue to come, they've only got to start capitalizing on that in a small way, and the whole scoring of the game will change. So sometimes it's a hidden statistic that points to a game being much closer, or a match being much closer than it actually appears on the scoreboard. I think breakpoint opportunities is the best one to look at when you're betting live, because it gives a true indication of how close a player is. Now, they might be getting in on the serve, winning points here and there on their opponent's serve. If that's the case, it's only a matter of time before they actually break that opponent's serve. You never know what a break of serve does to an opponent. Someone who's been holding serve religiously across the first, say, hour of a game, all of a sudden has their serve broken, and it can be a whole change to their mental approach to the game and their attitude to the game. They may go back into their shell, become more conservative, and that funny effect that occurs in tennis where they stop going for their shots actually makes them more beatable. Look for breakpoint opportunities. I think it's one of the best ways to access a momentum shift before it occurs when you're betting live on tennis. That's our five top tips to help you improve your live betting on tennis. At School of Bets, we have a full article that gives a whole heap more tips, very useful ones on how to improve your live betting on tennis. And that is in the video notes. So go and find that link and read that article if you want to delve deeper into this. It's worthwhile learning, because tennis is such a great sport to bet on live, and it's going to increase all these opportunities that you have as a sports bettor to get in, get some action, and turn your bankroll over and potentially become more profitable. So guys, get over to schoolofbets.com for all that sports betting wisdom that's just not that common. Please subscribe to the channel, like this video. I'm Jonathan, and I'm going to see you next time on the School of Bets.